of a classic emeritus, this is the one and only Miss Gina Devore.
USofA Classic Emeritus. Thank you. makes me sound a little too butch. I do have my butch moments for not dressed like this. How's everybody doing? How many out-of-town people in the house can be here? Only the out-of-towners. How many Atlantans can be here? Atlanta? Okay. Well, it is my pleasure to welcome each and every one of you to the first annual Mr. and Miss Black USofA contest. We have some wonderful surprises lined up for you tonight. We have some contestants that are really going to come out here and let you have it. They come from all over the country. As they introduce themselves in this, our first category, the presentation category, I want you to collectively give them all a humongous round of applause, make them all feel comfortable, and I guarantee you that they will come out here and give you 110%. So on the count of three, I want to see how much noise you can generate. Everybody, 1, 2, 3.
I bring you greetings from the Sunshine State, Florida, where I proudly represent Gay Black South Florida, USofA. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, for your consideration and your approval, I am your contestant number one, Mr. Marshawn Devine. Thank you.
Thank you, Marshawn. Mr. Black Texas USofA. Please sit back and relax and enjoy the pageant.
And at this time, let's meet contestant number three.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, panel of judges. For your consideration, I am your male contestant number three, Brandon Thomas. Coming here from New York, the Bronx, New York, to be exact. I'm representing the Pennsylvania pageant. And hope you have a good time, because I know I will. Enjoy the show.
Woo! Yeah! Let's meet our Miss Contestants this evening, starting with contestant number one.
Woo! Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am contestant number one, Miss Golden Hands, all the way from Austin, Texas. Woo! I hope you guys enjoy the show tonight.
Thank you, contestant number one. Let's give her a big round of applause. Let's welcome contestant number two.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished panel of judges. For your consideration, I am your contestant number two. I am the current reigning Miss Pennsylvania Black USofA. I am proudly sponsored by Hallmark. Why? Because they care to send the best.
This is contestant number two. How about a little applause? You're going to yell and scream for every contestant tonight, right? 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 Contestant number three.
And And my name is Daphne Bonet Iman. I'm proud of representing the gay black origin of the gay black system. And for this, I thank you.
Stage at this time to get ready for the talent competition. Give them all a big round of applause. And welcome to it, man. I thank you and good luck to each and every one of you. Ginger, you're a hit. Atlanta, GA! Okay, that's kind of pitiful, but I see y'all out there. I know y'all can't say too much. You gotta be real quiet tonight, because you're not here. I'm not here either. We have some wonderful, wonderful entertainment lined up for you this evening, and it is a pleasure always to be able to introduce this first entertainer. I've been in female impersonation for 30 years. I actually celebrated my 30 year anniversary back in November. And thank you. I'm often asked in interviews who is my favorite female impersonator, who do I idolize, who gave me inspiration when I was a young entertainer many years ago. And I always say it's this person here. She is an entertainer that I can tell you always comes to the stage and she always gives 110%. Always. She has held every title imaginable, including Miss Continental USA and of course Miss Florida. She is a Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together and give me a big round of applause. A humongous welcome all the way from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. She is the queen of queens. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Tiffany and Zelle.
you so, and you know you spread a whole lot of fertilizer all around while you were sowing it, baby. I learned a couple of years ago when I was visiting up in the great state of New Jersey that bitch stands for being in total control of herself. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So the next time somebody calls you a bitch, you tell them that we're in the business of changing definitions. Tell them that they call strong women bitches. They call successful women bitches. They call women who speak their minds bitches. That's why they call Roseanne a bitch. That's why they call Barbara Streisand a bitch. That's why they call First Lady for the second time Hillary Clinton a bitch. And that's why they call Ann and Andrew a bitch.
Just a couple of weeks ago, this next entertainer was crowned Miss Jungle for 2005. She is also a former Miss Black America. She's a former Miss K Georgia. And her list of accolades goes on and on and on and on as well. Ladies and gentlemen, she is known affectionately to us here in Atlanta as the Black Diamond of the South. Ladies and gentlemen, the beautiful
I'm
3, let's say congratulations, Paul, on being the new Miss. Number 1 through 3. Yes. Yeah, honey. She says from time to time, I may be an old broom, but I'm still sweeping. And still cleaning up, baby. We love her for that, the legendary. At this time, it's a pleasure for me to bring to the stage a young lady that I had the pleasure of crowning Miss Gay USofA Classic this year. She came armed and ready and prepared. She told me that she was gonna take it, and what can I say? She actually let the children have it. This is her second time being here in Atlanta. She was here for my birthday back in November. It's always a pleasure to introduce and just to be in the presence of this next entertainer. Ladies and gentlemen, please give me a big round of applause for Miss Gay USofA Classic 2005, the beautiful Ginger Manchester. You know how y'all are, honey. Speaking of, where's Nicole? Oh, I can't see. One of the most talented individuals on the planet. And speaking of wonderful entertainers, this next entertainer, she's a former Miss National, she's a former, current Miss Georgia USofA. She is current reigning Miss Gay Atlanta. She's a former Miss Black USA, different pageant system. That's wonderful. So ladies and gentlemen, holla if you know her. We're trying together for Miss Tamisha Iman.
Oh,
contest that Tanisha won was one of my newcomer contests years ago. And I tell you what, that makes me like really proud. It doesn't get much better than that. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Before we go on, we're about to go into our talent competition. But before we do that, I want to just take a moment and offer a word of thanks to the gentleman who is responsible for bringing this wonderful contest to Atlanta. Its entire inception was because of this gentleman. He lives in Fort Lauderdale. He is the CEO of USofA Pageantry. Ladies and gentlemen, please give me a big round of applause for Mr. Lou Haskell. Lou, a couple of new entertainers. Woo! What can I say? This next entertainer needs no introduction. I'm through. Ladies and gentlemen, Sophia!
And the Bible said, be thou loose, amen. So tonight we're gonna have a good time. Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. Can I get a young man to help me down? Amen. A young man over there in the red dress. You can fool some of the people some of the time. But you can't fool mom. How y'all doing? All right, Thomas, I see you judging tonight, so this is not gonna be fair. This Black History Month, honey, they're supposed to help us. What's your favorite black movie?
Thomas,
judge number three, and
Rod,
judge number four, and
Chris.
taking pictures and judging, we're watching you. I know who you're for, but we're watching you. If those scores are not consistent, Thomas, we're gonna take our scores and throw them out. You and Chris. All right? All right. Who y'all here to support?
Fine, I just ate a lot before I came.
Okay, this ain't just before you came. That's some years of eating.
What can I say, shit, it's Sonic.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we have 5 young ladies and 3 young men. And they have been doing a wonderful job. I saw them saying, here, take that to the DJ booth because it's not working, so they can really just put that one up. I know what they're trying to do. They're trying to get their microphone loud so they don't have to pay Tina. Y'all gonna go for this all night? Y'all? No, man. Man, she was out here getting proper and shit. I'm coming politically correct. Y'all know black fish pop, huh? Alright, ladies and gentlemen, shall we move? Contestant number 1 in town. Now, y'all cannot tip these contestants in town because you have something that you want to give them. Bring it over here and give it to me, and we worked out somewhere. I'm going to give it to them at the end of their number. Come over here and give it to me. Do not miss this step to test them. Now, if you're jipping, please make sure it's 5, 10, 20, 100 or a check. Because you come over here disturbing me with a dollar, I'm going to bust you in the face. This is a black passion. And we will go to the other side of the tracks. What I'm talking about. Can I get a stone? Because I don't really have no stools back there. Can I get a stone? So I'm going to sit on it. Ladies and gentlemen, this time, shuffle love for contestant number 1. This is Goldie Haynes. Give it up for Goldie Haynes. I'm not a kid. single?
No.
How long you been in your relationship?
4 years.
4 years? Can she cook?
Yeah, he can cook.
He? Who is your baby? That's your, oh. Hi. Hi, how are you? I thought you was fish. What's your favorite meal?
Spaghetti.
Spaghetti? You can throw it on my spaghetti? What's his favorite meal?
Curry chicken.
Curry chicken? She say you like curry chicken. You say your favorite meal is spaghetti. Since y'all confused, I probably can change. You like catfish? What's your name?
Mike.
Hey, Mike. When I grow up, I'm gonna be just like Mike. Did you watch the Super Bowl yesterday? You did? Ooh, okay. Well, I don't know me and watch the Super Bowl. You can get some over there, honey. Something ain't right, Mike ain't watching the game. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Hey, how you doing? Yesterday, did you?
No.
You didn't? I know you didn't. But if you had came out in the kitchen, you could have called me a bit like a guy. What's your name?
Quincy.
Quincy? Yes, this is not it. Where you from?
Ohio.
Ohio. Ooh, can you sing?
Yes.
Okay. You audition for American Idol?
I told you.
Hush. You audition for American Idol?
No.
Why?
I was in the kitchen. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, me.
Okay. I don't like the curse and stuff, but don't give me the curse because I will. But I ain't no woman to slap the shit out of you. But I will, okay? What's your name?
Jason.
Jason, you single?
I'm single.
Okay. What size shoe you wear?
13.
Ooh! You got a deep coochie. The what?
Wyndham.
The Wyndham? Which one?
10.
Oh, 10, what room number? Huh? Tell me now. Tell me now. Tell me now. You dumb as hell. in it?
Mm-hmm.
What does it smell like?
Rose.
Oh, that's real, honey. I'm out here putting out potpourri. What's your name? Actually, anybody ever tell you they're like Beyonce?
Lamar.
No. Good, they would be lying. Me, on the other hand, I look like Kelly. You think?
No. No, sir.
I didn't want to have to do this. Hold it, so. Now I'm going to have to touch. Child, y'all give it up once again for Miss Tiffany here, Adams, honey. I love that number, honey. Girl, I'm gonna go find that. You like that number? I know you would, you bitch. I'm not cussing no more. I'm already cussed out. I can't cuss no more because I don't usually cuss at these kind of events.